Good morning, children. How are you all? Hope you all are doing well. My name is Gayatri, English teacher of Dr. Besant School. Today, we are going to have our third standard English subject. So, children, let us do a general English grammar topic. That is nouns. So, today, let us recall about nouns. So, children, tell me, what are nouns? Can anyone tell me, give the answer to your parent who is sitting with you? What are nouns? Nouns are naming words. Nouns are naming words. Yes or no? Nouns are naming words. Naming words means which tells us the names of particular persons, places, animals, and things. They tell us the names of persons, places, animals, and things. To whatever the name you call with, to a person or a place or animal or thing, those are nouns. Let us see some examples now. What is there in my hand, children? Tell me what it is. It is a chalk piece. What it is? It is a chalk piece. We call this as chalk piece. So chalk piece is a noun. What it is? It is a duster. What it is? It is a duster. We call this as duster. So duster is a noun. What is this, children? What do you call this? This is a box. What it is? This is a box. We call this as box. So box is a noun. What it is? Can you tell me? Can anyone tell me what it is? This is a charger. We call this as a charger, right? So charger is a noun. What is there around my neck and my neck? This is a Bluetooth. We call this as a Bluetooth. So Bluetooth is a noun. In the same way, what it is, children? It is a book. We call this as a book. Book is a noun. If you see in your home, on the top of the floor, you can see the, over your head, you can see the fans. Fan is a noun. To the walls, lights. Lights are called nouns. Tables, chairs, bed, benches. All these are nouns. Even pencil, eraser, pen, sharpener. All these are nouns. We call them as nouns. So far till now, we learned some types of nouns also. These all are examples for things, right? Whatever I gave you now examples. For animals, can you give me some examples? Cat, dog, fox, lion, tiger. All these are nouns. We call them with those names only. Yes or no? Those are nouns. Next, places. Vijayanagaram, school, playground, zoo, Vishakhapatna, Hyderabad. These are places, right? All these are also nouns. Persons. Persons means my name is Gayatri, noun. Hemant, noun. Sunita, noun. Girl, noun. Boy, noun. Father, noun. Mother, noun. Whatever the word may be, if it is that name of a person or a place or animal or thing, we call them as nouns. So I think you all are clear with nouns. Next, let us see. Till now you learned about some types of nouns. Can anyone tell me, children, how many types of nouns I taught you so far? Yes, three types of nouns. How many types of nouns I taught you? Three types of nouns. What are they? What are they, children? First one is proper noun. First one is proper noun. Second one is common noun. Yes or no? And the last one is collective noun. And the last one is collective noun. These are all the three types of nouns we learned so far. Yes or no, children? First one is proper noun. second one is common noun, third one is collective noun. So now let us have a look on what are proper nouns, what are common nouns and what are collective nouns. So children, tell me, what are proper nouns? Tell me children, what are proper nouns? Proper nouns are nothing but the nouns which we call to that particular person or place or animal or thing. Suppose, see, what is my name, children? Tell me, what is my name? My name is Gayatri. Yes or no? My name is Gayatri. So you call me with the name Gayatri. Can you call all the teachers as Gayatri? No, you can call me only as Gayatri. So Gayatri is a proper noun. Same way, your names, your particular names. You all have your particular names, right? Can we call your friends with your name? No. Yes or no, children? So your name will be a proper noun. What is the name of a town, children? Vijayanagaram. What is the name of a town? Vijayanagaram. We can call this town only as Vijayanagaram. We can't call all the towns as Vijayanagaram. Yes or no? We can't call every town as Vijayanagaram, isn't it? Vijayanagaram in the sense, this place is only called as Vijayanagaram. So Vijayanagaram is a proper noun. Vishakhapatnam, proper noun. Mumbai, proper noun. Hyderabad, proper noun. India, proper noun. America, proper noun. And even something. So, Dr. Besant School. We have many schools in Vijayanagaram. We can't call every school as Dr. Besant School. Right, children? We can call this school only as Dr. Besant School. So Dr. Besant School is also a proper noun. Let us see some more examples for proper noun. See, children. So what is a noun? A noun names a person, place, animal or thing. Nouns are also called naming words. So now you see what are proper nouns. Proper nouns means special names given to persons, places, animals or things. For example, for Isma. Isma, can you see Isma? Can you call everyone with the name Isma? No, so Isma is a proper noun. New Delhi, it is the name of a city. Can you call every city as New Delhi? No, so New Delhi is a proper noun. Juggi, Juggi is the name of a donkey. Can you call every donkey as Juggi? We can call every donkey as donkey, but we can't call every donkey as Juggi, right? So Juggi is a proper noun. And see what last it is. It is a car. But the name of that particular car is Nano. We can't call every car as Nano, right? There are different cars, means like Swift, BMW, Rolls Royce, many cars we have. But Nano, yeah, they give, those all are, the names of that particular cars are proper nouns. And remember, proper nouns always start with capital letters. If whatever examples I have shown you so far, see, in every name, they started with capital letter only. Isma, I. New Delhi, N, D. Juggi, J. Nano, N. All these are proper nouns. You can easily identify proper nouns in the way that proper nouns always start with capital letters. Okay, children? Understood what are proper nouns? Tell me, what are proper nouns? Proper nouns are the nouns which you can call to a particular person or place or animal or thing. We can't call everyone with that proper noun. And in phonics, when we were reading phonics, we used to identify proper nouns like this. Yes or no? Proper nouns means it is the indication for proper noun. Did you remember that? Good. So now, next, coming to the second type of noun. What is the second type of noun, children? Common nouns. So what are common nouns? Common nouns are the nouns which you can call commonly to anyone. Suppose, who am I? I'm a teacher. Your Hindi teacher is a teacher. Your maths teacher is a teacher. Your social teacher is a teacher. Any teacher working in a school, we call them as teachers only. If you come to Gayatri teacher, I'll be the Gayatri teacher. So Gayatri will be the proper noun. But teacher, any teacher, even PET teacher is a teacher, dance teacher is a teacher, music teacher is a teacher. So teacher is a common noun. If I say teacher, all the teachers will see at me. Yes or no? So teacher is a common. table, any table, table only. Table is a common noun. Chair, any chair, chair only. Chair is a common noun. Fan, light, books, what do we say? Like that, mother. Your mother is a mother. My mother is a mother. His mother is a mother. Her mother is a mother. Mother, mother for anyone. So mother is a common noun. In the same way, father, brother, sister, uncle, aunt, all these are also common nouns. All these are also common nouns. And in phonics, when we are doing phonics grammar, we used to identify common noun like this. Yes or no, children? This is the identification symbol, indicating symbol that common nouns. Proper nouns, common nouns. We used to do in our first standard, right? Good. So common nouns are the nouns which we can commonly call to any person or place or animal or thing. Town. Vijayanagaram is a town. Srikakulam is a town. Like that. Town is any town is a town only. But we call Vijayanagaram is a proper noun. Town will be the common noun. Let us see some examples for common nouns also. Generally, what are the names we call with? See, general names used for people, places, animals or things. Suppose, girl. Any girl is a girl. We have many girls in the class, right? If I call you, hey girl, come here. If I stand in the class, there are many girls, children are sitting in the class. I say, hey girl, come here. Who is the girl will stand up and come? Yes or no? I can't say girl means all the girls will look at me. She is a girl, she is a girl, she is a girl, she is a girl, I am a girl. Yes or no? So girl is a common noun. If I say Pranati, you come here. So Pranati will be only one. That is a proper noun. She can come. In the same way, city, as I already told you the example for town, city. If it's New Delhi, it will be a proper noun. But city, any city is a city only. So city is a common noun. Donkey, any donkey, donkey only. Donkey is a common noun. Car, any car, car only. Car is a common noun. So understood, children? Understood? What are common nouns and what are proper nouns? Common nouns are the general names which we call to anyone. And this is not, we can't call a boy to a girl, girl to a boy. Means to all girls we can call with that name, girl, right? Yes or no? Madam, madam, you say. Any madam, madam only. Any miss, miss only. Any sir, sir only. If he is a sir. Those all come under common nouns. So to that particular or specific person or place, animal thing, if you call with that name, to that particular place or person, those are proper nouns. And remember, proper nouns always start with capital letters. Right, children? So I think you all are clear with common nouns and proper nouns. And the last one is collective nouns. What are collective nouns? Can anyone tell me? Can anyone tell me what are collective nouns, children? Right. So collective nouns are the nouns. See, when there is a group of nouns sitting in one place, belonging to same category, same features, we call that group with one particular name. Those are collective nouns. Suppose when we go to a market, if the market is very busy, what you'll say, my God, the crowd is over. There is an overcrowd in the market. Crowd, there is an overcrowd in the market. Crowd. So what is this crowd means? What is this crowd means, children? Crowd means lot of people in one place. Lot of people in one place. That is called crowd. In the same way, elephants. If you see a group of elephants walking, what can we say them? Herd of elephants. Herd of elephants means collective noun. Means group of elephants. When there is a group in one place belonging to same category with same features, that name is called collective noun. These will be the collective nouns. Understood? Suppose if we see many birds flying in the sky, group of birds, what we say? Flock of birds is flying in the sky. Flock in the sense group of birds. We can't call every animal with same collective noun. Different animals, different things will have different collective names. different names. Those names are collective nouns. For people we say crowd, for sheep we say flock, herd also we say. Like that for birds we say flock, right? For trees we say forest, for grapes we say bunch. Like that, for different animal, for different place, for different things, they have different collective, different names, group names. Those are called collective nouns. So let us see some examples with for these collective nouns. Right, children. So children, what can you see in this picture? You can see a tree. Yes or no? One tree. So we named it as a tree. And now tell me, what is this in the picture? Many trees. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Nearly 7, 8 trees are there. So we will write trees. For this we call it as a forest of trees. Means group of trees are called forest of trees. Here forest is a collective noun. Next. Grapes. 1 or 2 we say grapes. If many grapes, we call it as bunch of grapes. Bunch will be a collective noun. What is this animal, children? Wolf. One wolf, so wolf. Here if you observe, many. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 wolves. So we call them as a pack of wolves. Pack is a collective noun. Collection of same animals. Who is this? He's an athlete. He's trying for some sport. We call him as an athlete. Here he's only one, so we say him as athlete. Here if you observe, we have three. So we call them as a team of athletes. We call them as a team of athletes. Next. Who is he, children? He is a musician. Who is he? He is a musician. Only one, we call him as musician. If you observe here, you have four. So we call them as a band of musicians. We call them as a band of musicians. Band is a collective noun here. Same way, elephants. How many? Only one. So elephant. Here if you observe, four. So we call them a herd of elephants. Herd is a collective noun. What is this? A shoe. Shoe. So we call this a shoe, only one. When we have two, we call them as a pair of shoes. Same way, lion. How many? Only one. So we call this as a lion. Here if you see, many. So we call them a pride of lions. A pride means collective noun. Same way, book. How many? Only one. So we call it as book. Here if you observe, you have many. So we them say them. A pile of books or a stack of books. Pile or stack we can use for book. So it is a collective noun. Next, sheep. How many? Only one. So we call it as sheep. If there is more than one, we call them as a flock of sheep. Flock is a collective noun. See what it is, Ma? It is a fish. Only one. If you in the water, you can see lot of fish swimming at a time, moving at a time like this. Many fish you can see here. So we call them as a school of fish or a shoal of fish. School or shoal will be a collective noun. So children, I think you are clear with common noun, proper noun and collective noun. Collective nouns are nothing but same group. If we see of same category or with same features, we call them with one name. That name is called collective noun. Common noun is which we call generally the name which we use for calling. Those are common name, common nouns. And what are proper nouns? Proper nouns are nothing but the names which we call to that particular person, place or animal or thing. I hope you all are clear with this common, proper and collective nouns, children. In the coming classes, we'll do some exercises on this. Right, children? So we'll meet in the next class. Till then, take care and bye-bye.